Hello, Javad is here. In this video, we are going to learn how to create key plans for our Revit project. Key plans, as you see here, like this, are a great way to show our client, to show our plan readers or plan viewers, which part of the plan now we are talking about. For example, it will give them a glimpse about whole project, for example, like this, and we are telling them that this sheet is going to present this part of the plan. It's not really that hard. Let me bring it to the first step in this project and let's create all of them together. To do that, when you have the view in your sheet, you need to go to the annotate tab and from here click on detail line, or you can use DL shortcut for detail line. You need to use detail line because it will allow you to scale them very easily, and then just create some outline for your project. It's not really that important to make it very precise, but it is better to contain a good detail too. But for sake of this tutorial, I'm going to do it very fast, and we will going to create a parametric key plan symbol very easily for this project that we have here. Okay, let's go here. When you can't use snaps in here, for example, you can get this end. If you want to use freely for your drawing, press SX on your keyboard and you will have a free drawing. Okay, let me create a line from the end of this line. Let me bring it here. And let's go up. SX again. In here. As I said, it's not really that important. You just want to show a glimpse of the project. It's not really useful for dimensioning or those things. It just will give our plan viewers more details about the part of the project that we are talking about, or we have put our plans there. Okay, let's go top and let's close this one, or let me bring it in here. Let's close these two together. Okay, that's great. Go hover over one of these lines and press tab to select all of the lines. As you can see, I have all of the lines. Bring lines outside of here, and for example, I want to put this symbol in here, so I'm going to make it in this size. Go to scale and scale it to something much smaller. I think this is gonna be good, but let's test it. It's a little bit big. Let's make it smaller. Something like this, that's great. Place it in here, select all of these lines, press Ctrl C, and let's create our symbol family. To do that, go to the file menu and from here, click on new in family and in English parts. Let's go to annotation folder, and in here we are going to create a metric generic annotation. If this video has been so helpful so far, please don't forget to smash that like button. Please, it will help us a lot to create more videos like this. Okay, when your family is opened, you just need to press Ctrl V on your keyboard and bring those lines in here. That's great. The next process is to create some field regions for each part. Let's go to the create part and from here create a field region. You can use pick lines too. For example, I want to create a part for this part. Let's trim it, TR, click on finish, and you have your field region. Let's select our field region and let's press CS for create similar, or in here you can create similar from this field region. Let's create another one for this part of the plan. I'm using peak line to speed up our process instead of drawing each of them manually. Okay, let's trim this. Don't have this line. Let's pick it and let's trim it. Okay, that's great. Click on finish. Again, press yes and let's create a rectangle for this part. And or we can use peak lines because it's not all of them are not straight lines, and that can cause some problem. Okay, that's great. Click on finish. The next process is to create parameters for this. Select the first one. As you can see in properties palette, you have visible parameter. Click on this button in here and let's create a parameter for this. For example, part one, put it on instance because we want to change it in any view, and you can categorize it in any part you want. Other is great, no problem. Click on OK. Let's select the second part and let's repeat the process for the second part and for the third part. For our key plan symbol, very easily. Okay, let me bring it in here. Click on OK and OK. That's great. Let me save this family on my desktop. You can access all of the files from our Patreon page. And if you want some related products for Beam and Revit, you can go to our merchandise store too. Okay, that's great. Let's load this to our project. Let me place it in here. Let me delete these ones and let's bring it in here. Okay, that's great. But we don't want, for example, if your project is if you've placed all of the parts of this key plan, you can let them be turned on for all, let them be black for all of the parts. For example, let's go to this view and let's active this view. Let me bring the crop view. Let's show the crop view and let's bring it to this part, for example. And let me activate the annotation crop too. And let's bring it. Let's bring this line in here. Okay, that's great. We don't want to see the crop view anymore. We can't hide this one, or we can make it shorter like this. And let's inactive view and let's bring it in here. And in this part, select this one. As you can see, we have the parameters, but let me see what's the problem with the third part. Let's go back, and for the third part, we haven't done the parametering. Or the thing that I understood right now is we've created a type parameter for the third one. Let's go to the parameters and let's edit this and let's make it an instance parameter and let's load it again into our project. Let's overwrite it and let's select it again. As you can see, we want just for the third part, so we are going to uncheck these two and we have the third part. In another plans, you can go to annotation part. For example, in your second sheet, you can go to symbol and place your family freely for your second and third and so on for your sheets. I hope this video has been so helpful for you. If it was, please don't forget to like this video and share it with your friends and colleagues. And I will put another video in here that I will show you how to create market renders in Revit and Enscape, and it will give your clients a nice glimpse of your project. I will see you on the next session.